You think say you sabi Naija music? Old school or new school? Come show yourself for Gusto Guess the Song. You go win better better. Call the number where they appear for your screen so. Naija music, come win money.
Guys, welcome to Gusto Reactions. Once again, thank you so much for always liking, sharing, subscribing, of course, telling your friend. We see you, we see all your comments, and of course, we also see a lot of you already subscribing to the channel from all the way from Mali. Actually, yes. All the way from Mali, we see a lot of comments.
Francophone Africa.
Francophone Africa.
I need to go and learn some French. We are coming.
We're coming. We know, we see you guys. We understand the fact that you guys want to see a lot of more Francophone content on the channel, and we're going to bring that to you. Definitely. Guys, thank you so much for liking and sharing. Le Passé, Le Cui.
Don't say nonsense.
Iba One, Afrima. Aha. You understand that kind of thing now. You see, I saw Traore. I saw Jimmy something. I saw Jakarte. I saw a lot of, even Konate. You know, when I saw Konate, I was like, Konate Liverpool.
I don't understand you again.
Yeah, I saw a couple of big guys.
Liverpool, Francophone.
All the way from Mali, all the way from Senegal and the rest of them. Guys, thank you so much for doing that. Even the guys in Nigeria here, we love you. We appreciate all of you. Of course, it's all for the love of the African music culture. And of course, talking about that one, we know a couple of front liners in that one from Nigeria here. We have Wizkid. Of course, there's Wizkid FC. The fans always supporting Davido, of course, the 30BG gang every now and then. Burna Boy, as well, we know the outsiders. Now, in Nigeria, these are the major, major fandom, you know, thing in Nigeria. You're either an outsider,
for, Savage Soja,
Wizkid FC for music. Mm. Now, talking about fan base and fans and having like a closed group moving in one direction, when was the first time you saw this kind of thing? Like, how far can you remember?
Having a group
of fans.
Options. I think the people, the ones that open people's eyes the most has to be FC. I think they're the ones that opens people's eyes to fandom.
Before the likes of the FC.
But having a closed group, organized fan base.
Yeah.
I don't think there is. There's been a lot of scattered fan base.
Lala.
Which one?
There is.
Who?
When I was young, you get... I remember very clearly, I would see my landlord's children saying they are going for a meeting. Meeting of what? Meeting of Saeed Oshoppa fans.
Okay.
And everything. In Egbeda, Secretariat. Bro, Lala, to be honest, it was real. Like, these guys had ID cards and they were going for more like Sunday meetings.
I think at the local level, maybe, yes.
Yeah.
I don't think many people know this.
Yes.
Apart from those guys who were going.
Yes, Pasuma.
So it wasn't popular.
Fan base. They had the secretariat, they had secretary, they had president. They do election every year. You understand? But talking about Afrobeat, you know, the new generation and everything, of course, 30BG, Wizkid FC, Burna Boy.
Outside.
Now, how organized would you say these guys are in terms of having a proper structure?
I don't think there's any structure in place, to be honest. I think everybody drives around, because sometimes when, I mean, there's an issue and they are speaking, there's always two sides. There's always, it's fine or it's not fine. There's always a side that is do or die of the artist, regardless what the artist does, whether good or bad, they are there.
Yeah.
There's also the side of when the artist does bad, they say it's bad. When they say it's good, they say it's good. You get? And that doesn't take away the fact that they are loyal or they are crazy about the artist. It's just too different. I don't think particularly they meet. I know there are several groups of these fan bases that organize themselves. I mean, most effective, everyone knows, is FC. They know how to coordinate to perhaps say they want to trend something on Twitter, or they want to talk about something, or they want to hype up on particular day, or organize streaming parties. They've done that several, a couple of times. And every other person has followed suit. 30BG do have several groups, Telegram, WhatsApp, Outsiders as well, you name it. And then the new age guys, I mean, people who are able to cultivate the fan base to something
Fireboy
huge.
DML.
Fireboy DML, perhaps Laycon from Big Brother Niger.
Yeah.
Those guys are very in it. But I take it as far as saying, they have generals, they have secretary, they have this, they have that. I don't think they take it that far. They do know how to coordinate themselves for the common good of the artists. But I don't think they are very organized in terms of having paperwork, having titles for which who is who, and having membership or things like that. I don't think they are that organized.
But should they actually? you know, formalize this whole thing? Should it be just social media, or let's have a proper, what are the benefits? What are the benefits in the long run? How good or how well can having a proper structure go for these guys?
Well, it's a hard thing for me. I don't think it's needed. One, I don't think it's needed unless Wiz or Burnout or David want to be the one to organize and say, oh, I do have a fan club. For you to be a member of this fan club, you have to so and do this and do this. We know that it's a fan club that people have registered to be on. But I don't think any of them have that time to say they want to organize something like that. But if they do, of course, there's some benefits that can add in terms of formality of how we want. They can even use them as spokesperson for the fan club. There are several fan clubs. Football, what's it called? Teams have fan clubs, and people are registered to be on there. There's several groups that have different interests in the clubs. When it comes to, oh, we want to sell the club, we want to make new decisions, they all call together in the general meeting, and they're all doing their biddings for each other. Of course, you can use the same thing for music, but what would now be the common goal? What would be the they should set out to achieve when they do this? Would there be money involved for the people who are part of the fan club? Would they be paid salaries? What would be their aim exactly?
Well, you don't think they're limiting themselves to just social media? You don't think that there's this bigger picture of having a proper structure? And, you know, if it's not just social media, then there's no limit to what they can achieve if they actually have, you know, like a proper fan club. I mean, all this we see on social media are just anybody coming to type and everything. Some of them don't even know themselves before. They've not seen themselves before.
Yeah.
But you don't think that if they formalize everything, what are the pros and the cons of it?
Well, they can formalize even on social media. They don't have to make it physical because of how social media brings everybody to one particular place for whatever purpose. They can connect from them. In the sort of organization you're looking for, right? I think it has happened without them even realizing. Several times you see people, when Clubhouse was a thing, right? And Middle Lagos came about, there were several sessions of Clubhouse, on Clubhouse, of FC or any other person. They had their Clubhouse to talk about this. Even on Twitter spaces, people have come on and created a Twitter space and be like, oh, how Wizkid has saved your life, blah, blah, blah. And people have come on and talked. That's the sort of meeting that it's, you think, if they do physical, would benefit. But they are doing it on social media.
But they don't have a leader.
Must they have the leader? When things like this, you know how the easiest way sometimes to dabble all these things is having one leader, that if the leader messes up like this, everybody be like, we don't want this guy again, or we want this guy. And you know how it is with young Nigerians now. Nobody really follows anybody fully except for the main person. You get a lot of people that, I'll use FC as an example, you know, because a lot of them, you see them online. You can call them generals because they are anything, they are always there. These guys, you can see them as leaders, but they don't have the title as leaders because of how serious they've taken anything that's to do with Wizkid online. They gain notoriety, like they gain
recognition
generally that, yeah, this is one of the top FC guys. Oh, this is one of the top outsiders. This is one of the top Davido guys. You get. Everyone sees it. It's general that everybody sees it. Nobody doesn't have to be a number one or a number two or number three. Fine, if they decide to do it, but it has to be organized. People have to actually register to be a member of such. Would there be a fee to register to be of such? Would people be open to be a registered member? At the end of it all, maybe if they pay money to register, would they want to say, oh, we want to have some sort of convention? All FC fans, we're going to be meeting here.
I'm just saying about all the things you're saying now.
It's like, all fine and good.
They're grand ideas. The ideas that could take off social media. Get funding.
From
these guys.
Okay, then what's now the whole point? What's the point of a Burna Boy funding outsiders group? What does he want to do with it? He wants to appreciate his fans, his core fans. There are several people who do love his music and they don't care about any sort of fandom. They will just enjoy his music and they don't refer to people online that, oh, this is my guy is the best or this is my guy is not the best. It doesn't make them less valuable than the ones that are fighting or they're always defending online. You get? So what's the point for the, what's the, I don't see a clear benefit for the artist for having such a thing that, oh, it has to be organized and they have to fund them, you get, or appreciate them or whatever. They can't control them. Do you think Wizkid can control FC? If anything, sometimes if they come for Wiz himself, that why you know they do this. Davido doesn't have a mouth with 30 BG people. Till today, people will still diss them, people will shout online, concentrate online over people that are not saying, that don't even know who you are and things like that. It's valid. Fine, let them go and create their membership online. They can have their ID cards or whatever it is, but I still don't see what purpose it serves. As they are doing free for all right now, it benefits the artists. The artists don't even have to do anything. They don't have to say, Wiz doesn't have to say anything. FC is already hyping him up, right? Bonner, Davido, they don't have to say a word, but they're already being hyped up by their fans randomly. They're not organizing it. It's better if it's free for all like this, so that we know that nobody's orchestrating things from the back. Sometimes, even though sometimes you know that, oh, maybe it's perhaps there's somebody on that team that is sliding information to them and everything, which it makes more sense. But when you now start making it formal, and then you want to have some sort of engine behind you, that anytime you want to do anything, you now want to rely on them, be like, oh, it's time, oh, let's do this, let's do that, let's make it so bad. It now makes it look a bit fake.
What if the artists don't get involved and the fans decide to, you know what, we want to have? I mean, the benefit for the Fuji fans at the time was the fact that they were able to know who is who and all of that. You know, the era of just, you know, mingling together as Pasuma fans, Oshupa fans and everything at that time, going for weekly or monthly meetings, was the thing.
At that time, there was no social media and it had to be physical. But now there's social media. The mingling that you're talking about in the physical, they are mingling online every single day. And there are several groups that they have, they are mingling. So they are holding those meetings informally, which is still benefiting the artists. So, but I don't see what formally creating some sort of fan base or registered fan base.
Secretariat and the rest.
Yeah, I don't know what it would do for the artists. It will make the artists look some sort of mechanical, like, okay, you want to do something, you are going to now go and meet the general secretary of FC fan club that, oh, I want to do this, so how are we going to organize? Of course, it gives those guys some level of importance, but do you really give them that level of importance? Generally, when you just mention their name, that, oh, FC, I love you, FC, thank you for this, at least it gives everybody. But when you start being one person, imagine that one person now get beef with in your guy Whiskey, that being your guy Bonaboy. You now hold the artist that is supposed to be a fan or a stand to, you hold him to ransom, that I'm not doing anything, since you're not able to pay for this, you're not able to do that. Then it start being some sort of employment. Is that what they want to do? I don't think any of these guys want to employ any fan.
Okay, well guys, let's have your thoughts on that one. Fandom, fans, Teddy BG, Whiskey FC, Outsiders, Savage Soldiers, Icons, a lot of fans have different groups on social media. Is it time to take it from social media to the outside world? Outside social media, have a secretariat, have a president, have a vice president, and of course, just like the way, you know, back then with the Fuji artists, what benefit would having, you know, a physical fan club do for this artist and even do for the fans? Is it time to do that, or they should leave it on social media? Let's have your thoughts. What are the benefits? What are the pros and the cons, advantages and disadvantages of having a physical fan club for the Outsiders, Teddy BG, Savage Soldiers, Whiskey FC? Let's have your thoughts. Put them down below. We'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.